Coach Becker, thank you for joining me today. Just came back from beautiful Phoenix, Arizona for the Final Four. And I don't know if you remember last year when we talked after the national championship, but the biggest storyline really was the transfer portal.
Yeah.
A year later, that remains the same. But how have things kind of evolved from your perspective on how you guys are handling that?
Yeah, I mean, I thought, you know, we're learning each year. You know, the year we lost Ryan Davis and Isaiah Powell, our front court, all-league front court, kind of went after high major kids thinking we could get kids to transfer down. And we did get involved with some kids, but they ultimately stayed at that level. And the thing with the portal is it moves really quick. And so, you know, you chase the wrong kids and that don't work out. That's just time you lose where other kids are kind of coming off the board. I thought last year we did a great job of finding productive mid-major kids that were looking for a different opportunity to come to a winning program and play in the NCAA tournament. And, you know, those kids this year worked out really, really well. And so I think that's, you know, we're going to kind of stick to that formula of finding productive mid-major kids. You know, the first question a lot of times is how much are we paying, which we don't have NIL. So so we kind of got to weed through that. But there's, you know, and our sweet spot is, you know, productive mid-major kids that want to play in a winning program. And you know, we've been fortunate last year to find those kids, and we're, you know, making some good traction with some kids again this year looking for the same thing.
When you're actually looking at these players, how much are you evaluating, like, what your current roster looks like and what you need versus the type of student athletes that you want to bring into this program?
Yeah, I think it's a combination of both, right? We want to try to fill holes. And what I've tried to do here is kind of a hybrid of having freshmen and then, you know, complementing the roster with transfers. And, you know, and so I think for me, there's a moral dilemma sometimes where, you know, you have young kids that, might not quite be there yet, but, you know, they need the opportunity kind of, and you kind of got to work through it. And then, you know, having an opportunity to get kids out of the portal that have that are more proven. And so I'm trying to find a balance, and I'm, and my loyalty is always to the guys that have been in the program, but it's, but yeah, so that's kind of the challenge here, where it's you know, I hope a lot less transactional probably than a lot of other programs, you know, I want to make sure we have the best team possible for our fan base and for the seniors on our team, that, you know, that we can give ourselves the best chance to win at the highest levels and make the NCAA tournament again. And so I'm trying to weigh all these factors in when selecting the kids. But as far as the players themselves, you know, they have to be high character. They have to be, you know, great students. They have to be to care about the right stuff, and you know, I don't get in, you know, I've never promised anyone anything coming into this program. I don't promise a starting position. I don't promise shots or minutes. I present an opportunity where I think we need someone that can do certain things. So I, you know, everyone's been given an opportunity, and so then you got to come here and earn it, and that, you know, that's that messaging has not changed.
Final bit on the transfer portal. You see, right after a lot of mid-major seasons finished up, kids entering the transfer portal. Yeah. Some of the most talented players in the country. That hasn't really been the case here. You had a couple guys, Jackson Skipper, yeah, the top one that left. But how have you been able to keep kind of like your core talent in this new era?
Yeah, I think that's a great question, and something I think it speaks to the experience that the guys are having here. I think they the winning certainly helps. The basketball matters here, the community, the fan base. I think those are two big things, but I think, you know, the relationships, how they're treated, how they're coached, they know they're getting coached really well. Their teammates, they're around other really good people. And so I think it's been a combination of things, but yeah, I mean, I think I have this right, but I think 12 out of the 14 all-league guys last year from the America East, for instance, have either graduated or in the transfer portal. That might be 11 now that Earl Timberlake has come out of it, but, you know, three of those guys, you know, or two of those guys are on our team, a couple on Lowell, and then Earl down at Bryant. So it is a phenomena, so to speak, that we've been able to keep our best young players here, but you just wonder at some point if that's going to change. Hopefully not. Hopefully we can get a collective going here. Hopefully we can start to, you know, financially support the guys, not at the level that Maryland is or Duke, but at a level where it's fair, you know. And so so I know our administration's working towards that, and hopefully at some point we can, you know, we can get there. But yeah, I feel super fortunate. We should all feel really fortunate that you know, that we haven't lost any, you know, lost significant part of our roster to the portal.
The idea of having a collective, not as common for schools of this size, but do you feel like it's something eventually that you'll need to adapt just to kind of be able to stay afloat?
Yeah, you know, it's the, you know, I think that the, in, you know, the idea that players are getting compensated is great, you know, but, you know, at the Final Four, at our coaches' convention, at meetings, just talking to other coaches, it's, you know, we need to have some legislation. We need to have, you know, maybe even a commissioner of college basketball. We need to put some parameters, some rules, because right now it's, you know, the wild, wild west, you know, and you know, players are being contacted. You know, high major programs have one, two, three people on staff that are monitoring all mid-major players and leagues, and guys are being contacted, you know, tampered with, contacted illegally, you know, going on visits before they're even in the portal. There's no, you know, it's just, so it makes it really, really hard at our level to keep our talent. And again, why I'm so fortunate that we've been able to do that, because it's not the norm.
So luckily for you guys, you're bringing back a lot of talent, and you mentioned, you know, guys like Shamir Bogues and TJ Long, getting guys that have multiple years of eligibility left and having the opportunity to continue to develop. Aleri Iofalia, another transfer guy that came is that something that you kind of pitch to prospective players, like, these are some of the success stories that we've had in the past, and this is what you could turn into if you actually have multiple years left?
Absolutely. Absolutely. It's a big part of our recruiting pitch. Is we have a track record of, you know, in, you know, if it's a freshman, of developing freshmen, guys staying for 4 years, you know, Anthony Lamb, Trey Bell Haynes, Steph Smith, Ryan Davis, Isaiah Powell, you know, long list of the Duncans, of guys that have done that. And then in the transfer portal, we've had a lot of success stories there where we've, you know, guys that, you know, revitalized careers, guys with multiple years turning into all league players, turning into professionals. And so, you know, so yeah, we have a really good track record in both scenarios that we can really show the guys. And yeah, I think that's been a huge part of our pitch.
How much of a relief was it to hear that TJ would not require surgery after what was a scary situation?
I was so happy for him. I mean, it was just, you know, in that moment, it just, you know, the air came out of the building, at least for Vermont fans and Vermont program, where, you know, the game's basically over, you know, and then you're seeing him, you know, go down like that in pain, and you're thinking, oh God, like, is it an ACL? Is he going to miss all of next year, you know, on the, you know, a last play of this season, you know, in kind of a, you know, meaningless minute there, minute and a half, 2 minutes, whatever was left. So yeah, I was so happy and grateful for him. And you know, obviously he, you know, he's a great player and a better kid, and his parents were there and they're unbelievable. So I was happy for everybody involved, but especially TJ.
And heading into the offseason, I know there's still a couple dominoes to fall as far as, you know, who might be coming into the program transfer wise but from what you have now currently on campus, what are you looking for as far as a developmental perspective going into next season? Because you had last year guys like Aleri Iofalia took a big jump over the summer and became one of the most elite defenders in the region. So, like, what sort of things are you looking for there?
Yeah, I mean, I think there's a lot we need, you know. So with losing Aaron, Matt, and Brenton, we're losing a lot of shooting, you know. So we've got to, you know, and you know, this was probably our worst offensive year, you know, only get 47 against Duke, and we were elite defensively. So, you know, we would probably focus a little bit more on the offensive side of the ball this offseason. And, you know, Nick's got to develop more. I thought he had a good year and really, you know, made some, you know, made two huge threes in the Lowell game, but he's got to be a better, more consistent perimeter shooter. You know, we've got to find some back to the basket ability to throw it in. We only kind of threw it inside when we had a mismatch. So we need some guys to develop. Seth Joba, I thought, you know, had, you know, got better as the year went on, wasn't a part of the rotation, plays in the Duke game, and you know, had, you know, I really felt good about him out there. So, you know, maybe he's a guy that we can develop as a back to the basket guy, but we've got to be able to throw it inside, you know, big, when our big is being guarded by a big, which we didn't do at all this year, which made it really hard to play offense. And so we've got to develop that, maybe find it in the portal, maybe, you know, probably best case a combination of those two things. You know, we kind of had to go to Shamir as our post-up guy later in the year. And so that's still going to be an option. You know, I think, you know, again, more guys that can kind of, Shamir was the one guy that could kind of get into the paint at will. You know, we need to find a little bit more of that. You know, again, maybe that's in the portal, we find someone like that. And then the two TJs, you know, watching UConn, and everyone now wants to play like UConn and stuff like that, but, you know, use them more, you know, with off-ball stuff, and maybe a little bit like Cam Spencer was used with UConn, use them in ball screens a little bit more because of their threat to shoot, and really put pressure on the defense that way. So there's a lot of stuff we're throwing around the office, but it's really exciting. I mean, forget who we might add in the portal, the group of kids we have coming back. You know, we got a lot of guys coming back with great experience. We have young guys that hopefully are ready to take it the next step. And so I'm really excited about the potential of next year, and then thinking, you know, what pieces we may add in the portal to kind of complete our roster. We'll be really competitive again next year. To you know, playing time will be really competitive. But I think we need to add some size and some back to the basket, a guy that can touch the paint, and then always shooting, you know, always shooting. So we'll see. We'll see what happens.
All right, wrapping things up after a third consecutive trip to the NCAA tournament. Coach Becker, thank you so much for your time, and good luck with the rest of the offseason.
Thanks, no, I appreciate it.